हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ऑल इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल ऑल अबाउट सिविल इंजीनियरिंग बाय प्रवीण माने। दिस इज प्रोफेसर प्रवीण माने डिलीवरिंग यू ऑडियो वीडियो सेशन ऑन एमसीक्यू प्रैक्टिस सेशन फॉर इंजीनियरिंग मैकेनिक्स, स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटेरियल्स और स्ट्रक्चरल सब्जेक्ट्स रिलेटेड विद द सिविल इंजीनियरिंग। सो पार्ट वन फॉर दिस इज द पार्ट वन लेक्चर ऑफ दिस ऑडियो वीडियो सेशन फॉर एमसीक्यू प्रैक्टिस सेशन फॉर सब्जेक्ट इंजीनियरिंग मैकेनिक्स। सो आई एम हैविंग टोटल 13 ईयर्स ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस, इन दैट 5 ईयर्स ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल एक्सपीरियंस एंड 9 ईयर्स आर 8 प्लस ईयर्स ऑफ टीचिंग एक्सपीरियंस। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम विल डायरेक्टली गो फॉर द सेशन। सो फर्स्ट हियर आई एम गिविंग यू अ न्यूमेरिकल, that is the MCQ numerical, their option and then correct answer and the solution for the same answer. So here a prismatic bar kilonewton is subjected, prismatic bar kN is subjected to force as shown in figure below. The support reaction at K is, so this is prismatic bar KLMN, the forces are like this 3P, P and 2P. So what will be the reaction at K? So its answer will be 4P. So how it answer comes? So free body diagram of the given bar is shown below. RK this way, this way. For equilibrium of forces, summation FH is equal to 0. That is forces in horizontal direction is equal to 0. So this is the equilibrium equation. Already we have studied. Now RK minus RK. Minus RK. So this side, left side forces are negative, right side forces are positive. So this is the sign convention. So minus RK plus 3P minus P plus 2P is equal to 0. RK is equal to 4P. Then principal plane is a plane on which shear stress must be equal to 0 and normal stress may or may not act. So this is the principal plane. So here the definition, principal plane is a plane on which shear stress must be 0 and normal stress may or may not act. Then the sum of moment of inertia of an area about any two orthogonal axes passing through a point remains constant. This constant equals to polar moment of inertia. So polar moment of inertia Iz is equal to Ix plus Iy is equal to Ix dash plus Iy dash. So this is the sum of moment of inertia of an area about any orthogonal axis passing through a point remains constant. Then maximum bending moment for simply supported beam loaded as shown figure is. So this is a simply supported beam. Bending moment is given. The loading conditions are given. So what will be the maximum bending moment? Maximum bending moment will be 2m divided by 3. 2m divided by 3. So where it will be? So we'll point. First we'll find the reactions. Ra is equal to Ra is equal to minus Rb is equal to net moment divided by net span is equal to M divided by L. Reactions are M divided by L and minus M divided by L respectively. Now bending moments. M moment at A is equal to 0. So moment at A is equal to moment at B minus is equal to M divided by L into 2L divided by 3. So moment is equal to this M divided by L into distance, force into distance, reaction into distance is equal to 2M divided by 3. MB, M divided by L into 2L divided by 3 minus M is equal to minus M by 3. Moment at C is equal to 0. So clearly M max, moment maximum is equal to 2M divided by 3 and will be at B. Then bending moment at x location in a rectangular section beam, cross section area 3600 mm² is given as m is equal to 12x minus 3x² kilonewton meter. 0 is less than equal to x is less than equal to 4. So x is 0 to 4, in between 0 to 4. The maximum transverse shear stress in MPa, that is megapascal, in the beam at x is equal to 1 meter is rounded to one decimal place. It is, answer is 2.5. How it comes? So here we'll see. Given data, m is equal to 12x minus 3x², x is 0 to 4, a is equal to 3600 mm². We know that shear force F is equal to dm divided by dx is equal to 12 minus 6x. At x is equal to 1 meter, F is equal to 12 minus 6 into 1 is equal to 6 kN. Also for rectangular section, tau max is equal to 1.5 tau average. Therefore, tau max is equal to 2.5, that is 1.5 into F divided by A is equal to 1.5 into 6000 divided by 3600. So it is 2.5 MPa. A hollow shaft of outer diameter 50 mm and thickness 5 mm is subjected to a twisting moment of 1200 Nm. The minimum torsional shear stress in the shaft is 66.249 MPa. So given data, DO is equal to 50 outer diameter, then T is equal to 5 mm thickness. So your figure is there. Tau minimum inner, tau maximum at outer section, tau is equal to 1200 Newton meter. So K is equal to DI divided by DO is equal to 50 minus 2 into 5 divided by 50 is equal to 40 divided by 50 is 0.8. For hollow circular shaft, tau max is equal to 16T divided by pi D outer cube into bracket 1 minus K raised to 4. K already we have calculated. So we have D outer, we have T. T is 1200 Newton meter, tau twisting moment. So tau max is equal to 82.01 Newton per MPa. That is Newton per mm² or MPa. From similar triangles, tau minimum divided by 20 is equal to tau maximum divided by 25. Tau minimum is equal to 66.25. So this is the angle. This is the first triangle. This is the, well, we are assuming this is a second triangle. So comparing this one triangle with another triangle, so we'll get tau minimum is equal to 66.25 MPa. Then a simply supported beam of constant flexural rigidity EI and length 2L carries a concentrated load P at its midspan, where the deflection under the load is sigma. Deflection is delta. If the cantilever beam of the same flexural rigidity EI but length L is subjected to load P at its free end, then the deflection at the free end will be, deflection will be 2 delta, 2 times delta. So we'll see case 1. Simply supported beam with load P and constant EI, length 2L, RA and RB. So Y X is equal to 1 by 2. Y X equal to 1 by 2 is equal to sigma. Sorry, delta. Delta is what? It is the deflection. Deflection at midpoint. Delta is equal to WL cube divided by 48 EI. P into 2L cube divided by 48 EI is equal to PL cube by 6 EI. In second case, cantilever beam L, so YB is equal to PL cube divided by 3 EI. Deflection at point B is equal to PL cube by 3 EI. YCB divided by YSSB is equal to YCB divided by YSSB. That is the Y cantilever beam divided by Y simply supported beam is equal to Y cantilever beam divided by सिग्मा पी एल क्यूब डिवाइड बाई 3 EI डिवाइड बाई पी एल क्यूब डिवाइड बाई 6 EI इज इक्वल टू 2. सो वाई सी बी एट फ्री एंड कैंटिल्योर बीम इज इक्वल टू 2 टाइम्स डेल्टा. सो दैट विल बी द आंसर. देन अ थिन सिलिंड्रिकल शेल ऑफ 500 mm डायमीटर इज रिक्वायर्ड टू विदस्टैंड एन इंटरनल फ्लूइड प्रेशर ऑफ 5 N/mm². इफ द मैक्सिमम टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ अ प्लेट मटेरियल इज 400 N/mm² एंड द इफिशियंसी ऑफ द जॉइंट इज 65%, द मिनिमम थिकनेस इन mm ऑफ सिलिंड्रिकल शेल बाय कंसिडरिंग फैक्टर ऑफ सेफ्टी ऑफ 4 इज 19.23. सो हाउ दिस आंसर कम विल सी. सो गिवन डेटा डी इज इक्वल टू 500 mm, पी इज इक्वल टू 5 N/mm², एस वाई टी इज इक्वल टू 400 N/mm², एफ फैक्टर ऑफ सेफ्टी इज इक्वल टू 4. सो अलाउबल स्ट्रेस इज इक्वल टू एस वाई टी दैट इज द टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ इन मटेरियल, टेंसाइल स्ट्रेंथ इन प्लेट मटेरियल. वाई टी डिवाइड बाय फैक्टर ऑफ सेफ्टी इज इक्वल टू 400 / 4 इज इक्वल 100 N/mm² फॉर मिनिमम थिकनेस पी डी पी इंटू डी डिवाइडेड बाय 2 T/N. सो 100 N/mm², दिस इज द 100 N/mm. सो टाउ मिनिमम, दिस इज टाउ मिनिमम. टाउ मिनिमम इज इक्वल टू 5 × 500 डिवाइड बाय 2 × 100 × 0.65 इज इक्वल टू 19.23. सो टाउ मिनिमम इज इफिशियंसी, टाउ ईटा, दिस इज टाउ एंड ईटा, दिस इज ईटा, ईटा नीटा, नीटा नीटा, सॉरी नीटा इज द इफिशियंसी, दिस इज नीटा, नीटा इज द इफिशियंसी. नाउ अ स्टील कॉलम हैज प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी लिमिट 240 MPa एंड मॉड्यूलस ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी इज 210 GPa गीगा पास्कल. द मिनिमम वैल्यू ऑफ स्लेंडरनेस रेशियो अप टू विच यूलर्स फॉर्मूला मे बी यूज टू डिटरमाइन द बकलिंग लोड ऑफ द कॉलम इज 92.93. सो हाउ 92.93 कम्स विल सी. सो गिवन डेटा इज इक्वल टू 210 GPa, सिग्मा सी इज इक्वल टू 240 MPa, सिग्मा सी इज इक्वल टू 240 MPa, लैमडा मिनिमम स्लेंडरनेस रेशियो, स्लेंडरनेस रेशियो फॉर कॉलम विल कैलकुलेट. लैमडा मिनिमम इज इक्वल टू स्क्वेयर रूट ऑफ पाई स्क्वेयर ई डिवाइडेड बाय सिग्मा सी इज इक्वल टू, पुट द वैल्यूज, इज इक्वल टू 92.93. सो दिस विल बी द आंसर. नाउ फॉर द आई सेक्शन एज शोन इन फिगर बिलो, द एरिया मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया, द एरिया मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया अबाउट सेंट्रॉइडल हॉरिजॉन्टल एक्सिस इज डॉट डॉट इंटू 10^6 mm^4. द आंसर विल बी 11.413. सो हाउ इट कम्स विल सी. गिवन डेटा बी, सो दिस इज द फिगर बी, मैक्सिमम विड्थ ऑफ सेक्शन इज 100 mm, एच इज इक्वल टू एच टोटल हाइट इज इक्वल टू 80 + 20 + 20, सो 120. स्मॉल बी इज इक्वल टू 100 - 30, स्मॉल बी इज हियर 100 - 30 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 इज इक्वल टू 35, स्मॉल बी हियर, एंड एच इज इक्वल टू स्मॉल एच इज इक्वल टू 80 हाइट ऑफ फ्लाइंग. सो दिस पोर्शन वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड, स्मॉल बी इज दिस पोर्शन, स्मॉल बी इज ओनली वन साइड वी आर टेकिंग. देन मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया अबाउट सेंट्रॉइडल हॉरिजॉन्टल एक्सिस, सेंट्रॉइडल हॉरिजॉन्टल एक्सिस इज इक्वल टू आई एक्स इज इक्वल टू बी कैपिटल बी इंटू कैपिटल एच क्यूब डिवाइडेड बाय 12 माइनस 2 इंटू ब्रैकेट स्मॉल बी इंटू स्मॉल एच क्यूब डिवाइडेड बाय 12. सो आई एक्स इज इक्वल टू, पुट द वैल्यूज, 100 × 120³ / 12 - 2 × ब्रैकेट 35 × 80³ / 12 सो आई एस इज इक्वल टू, आई एस आई एक्स इज इक्वल टू 11.41 इंटू 10^6 mm रेस्ट टू 4. नाउ अ सिंपली सपोर्टेड बीम ऑफ लेंथ 6 मीटर कैरीज अ यूनिफॉर्मली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड लोड ऑफ 2 किलोन्यूटन पर मीटर थ्रू आउट इट्स स्पैन. द बीम सेक्शन इज रेक्टेंगुलर विथ विड्थ 60 mm एंड डेप्थ 120 mm. The bending stress at a point 20 mm below top surface at section 2 meter from left support is approximately how much? It is 37 MPa. But how it is? So solution, given data L is equal to 6 meter, W is equal to 2 kN per meter, B small b is equal to 60 mm, D small d is equal to 120 mm, Y is equal to 120 divided 2 minus 20 is equal to 40 mm. So here I have shown the figure. This is cross section. So bending moment at the section of interest is given by M is equal to 6 into 2 minus 6 into 2 minus 2 into 2 into 1. 6 into 2. 6 into 2 minus 2 into 2 into 1. So 1. It is 2 into 2 into 1. So 8 kN meter. Bending stress sigma is equal to M divided by I into Y is equal to 8 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 60. Into 120 cube divided by 12 is equal to into 60 minus 20 is equal to sigma is equal to 37 MPa. So now a timber beam of circular section is to be designed to carry shear force of 10 kN. Shear force of 10 kN. If allowable shear stress is 5 MPa, the safe minimum diameter of the section is 58.3 mm. So data, given data F is equal to 10 kN, tau bar is equal to 5 MPa, tau bar is equal to allowable shear stress, tau bar means allowable shear stress. For safe design, tau max should be less than equal to tau bar, that is the allowable shear stress. So 4/3 F divided by A should be less than equal to tau bar. So A will be greater than 4F divided by 3 into tau. So pi by 4 d square is greater than equal to 4 into 10,000 divided by 3 into 5. So d is greater than equal to 58.27 mm. So it will be, so it should be minimum 58, but it should be greater than this. But here asked set minimum diameter. Minimum diameter is 58.27. Now, a solid circular shaft having modulus of rigidity G is equal to 80 GPa is to be designed to carry 1600 Newton meter of torque. The shear stress is not to exceed 65 MPa, whereas angle of twist is not to exceed 1 degree in 2 meter length. The safe minimum diameter in mm of the shaft is. So, solution, how we are giving? G is equal to 80 GPa, T is equal to 1600 Newton meter, allowable shear stress tau bar is equal to 65 MPa, theta bar is equal to 1 degree, allowable angle of twist, L is equal to 2 meter, maximum shear stress criteria, tau max is less than equal to tau minimum, that is the tau allowable stress, shear stress. So 16 T divided by pi D cube is less than equal to tau bar. So 16 to 1600 into 10 cube divided by pi d is less than equal to 65. So d is equal to greater than equal to 50.05. angle of twist criteria, theta max should be less than equal to theta bar. So tl divided by gj less than equal to theta bar. So 1600 into 10 raised to 3 into 2000 divided by 80,000 into pi d raised to 4 divided by 32. Here 80, 2000, we have converted in length in millimeter and the stress in Newton per mm square. Newton per mm square. So d should be greater than 69.51 mm. So shape minimum diameter of the shaft satisfying both criteria 69.51. So here it should be greater than 50, it should be greater than 69.51. So we should take maximum. So it should satisfy both the conditions, maximum shear stress criteria and angle of twist criteria. Now a steel cylinder whose Young's modulus is E is equal to 210 GPa, gigapascal, of 90 centimeter long and 15 centimeter internal diameter is made from plates of 5 mm thickness. When the cylinder is subjected to internal pressure of 7 MPa, the increase in volume due to internal pressure is 16 centimeter cube. The values of Poisson ratio and modulus of rigidity are respectively. So we have to find out here Poisson's ratio and modulus of rigidity. So answer will be 0.24 is the modulus of Poisson's ratio and 84.4 GPa is the modulus of rigidity. How it comes? So given data, E is equal to 210 GPa, L is equal to 900 mm, D is equal to 150 mm, T is equal to 5 mm, P is equal to 7 MPa, delta V is equal to 16 into 10 raised to 3 mm cube. So volume is equal to V is equal to pi by 4 D square, L is equal to 5 by 4 150 square into 900 mm cube. So also delta V is equal to epsilon V into volume. Epsilon V is the strain. So 16 into 10 raised to 3 is equal to PD divided by 4 T into bracket 5 minus 4 mu into pi by 4 into 150 square into 900. So 4.024 minus is equal to 5 minus 4 mu. So mu is equal to 0.976 divided by 4 is equal to 0.243 is the Poisson's ratio. Now we know that G is equal to E divided by 2 into 1 plus mu is equal to 210 divided by 2 into 1 plus 0.243 is equal to 84.4 GPa. So this will be the answer. Now a beam of 4 meter in length is simply supported at the ends and carries a uniformly distributed load of 5 kN per meter throughout its length. The strain energy stored in the beam is, take Young's modulus is equal to E is equal to 200 GPa and moment of inertia I is equal to 1200 centimeter raised to 4. The answer is 44.44 Newton meter. So here solution. So here as per instructions given, we have drawn the figure. So due to symmetry, Ra is equal to Rb. Due to symmetry, Ra is equal to Rb is equal to 5 into 4 divided by 2 is equal to 10 kN. So this will, we are calculating simply the reactions. Then strain energy in bending, U is equal to integration 0 to L mx square dx divided by 2 EI. So here mx is equal to Ra into x minus wx square divided by 2 is equal to, put the values, 10 in x minus wx square divided by 2 is equal to 10x minus 2.5x square kilonewton per meter, kilonewton meter. So now U is equal to integration 0 to L 10x minus 2.5x square bracket square dx divided by 2 EI. So 0 to 4. So 4 meter length beam. So 0 to 4 integration. 0 to 4 100x square plus 6.25x raised to 4 minus 50x cube into dx divided by 2 EI. So 10 raised to 6 divided by 2 EI. We'll solve this integration. 100 into x cube divided by 3 plus 1.25 x raised to 5 minus 12.5 x raised to 4, 0 to 4 Newton meter. So we'll put the value and we'll got the answer 44.44 Newton meter. So now in a biaxial state of stress, the stress component are sigma x is equal to 100 MPa, sigma y is equal to 100 MPa and tau xy is equal to 0. The in plane maximum shear stress in the member is, maximum stress in the member is 0. zero, as we know. What we know? So this is the figure. So tau maximum in plane is equal to sigma 1 divided by sigma 2 divided by 2. 100 minus 100 divided by 2 is equal to 0. Simple. At a point in a stressed body, sum of the normal stresses acting on perpendicular faces of an arbitrary oriented plane stress element is always constant and independent of angle of orientation of the element. So its solution: sum of the normal stresses acting on perpendicular faces of an arbitrarily oriented plane stress element is called stress invariant. I1 is equal to sigma x plus sigma y is equal to constant. Let the element P be subjected to a state of stress as shown below. After rotating the element P by an angle theta in counterclockwise direction, the new state of stress on an element is, say, Q. The above two states of stresses are shown below in Mohr circle. So we have shown these stresses in the Mohr circle. So from above Mohr circle, sigma x 1 plus sigma y 1 divided by 2 is equal to sigma x 2 plus sigma y 2 divided by 2. So sigma y plus sigma x plus sigma y is equal to constant, which is valid for an angle theta. Then if a bronze sphere whose Young's modulus is 100 GPa and Poisson's ratio is 0.25 of diameter 30 mm is dropped into the sea of 3 km depth, then the change in diameter of the sphere will be, considered density of the seawater is equal to 1000 kg per meter cube and g is equal to acceleration due to gravity, 10 meter per second square. So its answer will be 4.5 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm. So solution: given data E is equal to 100 GPa, mu is equal to Poisson's ratio 0.25, d 30 mm, h is equal to 3000 meter, rho is equal to 1000 kg per meter cube, g is equal to 10 meter per second square. When the sphere is dropped into the sea, it will be subjected to hydrostatic state of stress. So sigma is equal to P is equal to rho into gh is equal to 1000 into 10 into 3000 is equal to 30 MPa. Now delta V divided by V, change in volume divided by volume, original volume, is equal to 3 sigma divided by E into bracket 1 minus 2 mu. So therefore 3 into bracket sigma delta D divided by D, change in diameter divided by original diameter, is equal to 3 sigma divided by capital E into bracket 1 minus 2 mu. Delta D divided by 30 is equal to 30 divided by 100 into 10 raised to 3, 1 minus 2 into 0.25. So delta D is equal to 4.5 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm. So this will be the solution. You should know the formulas. You should remember the formula and you should know the basic things to solve this MCQ session. So the compound beam ABCDE shown in figure below consists of two beam AD and DE joined by hinged connection at D. The loads on the beam consists of 4 kN force at the end of bracket attached at point B and 2 kN force at the midpoint of beam DE. So this will be the bracket and this will be the force. The magnitude of the bending moment at point C, in kN meter in the compound beam ABCD is, so we need to calculate the magnitude of bending moment at point C. So answer is 2. How it comes? So compound beam we have written here, we have to find at C, correct? Due to symmetry of the beam DE, reaction RD is equal to RE is equal to 1 kN. Bending moment MC is equal to minus RD into 2 is equal to minus 2 kN meter. Thus it is concluded that magnitude of bending moment at point C is 2 kN meter. So here is the bending moment diagram and here is the shear force diagram for the same beam. First you need to solve it and then you need to find. So this is symmetry. So symmetry, the bending moment at point D will be same, and same bending will be carried here by means of due to this load RD. So first we will calculate the reactions RA and RB, and then will parts will divide this beam into two parts. This is one part, this is another part, and due to symmetry we'll find bending moment at D, and same bending moment will be applicable at point C. So this will be the bending moment for beam. Then a beam with overhang carries one point load acting downward and the other upward as shown in figure below. The clockwise movement P into B is applied at each support. The bending moment at the midpoint of the beam is it is zero. Why is zero? We'll see. At midpoint is C. So we have drawn the free body diagram of this. Then summation MB is equal to zero. Summation MB is equal to zero. So RA into L is equal to 2PB minus B plus L into P minus PB. So RA is equal to P upward. So we'll calculate RA. RB. MC is equal to minus P into B plus L by 2 plus RA is RA into L by 2 plus P into B. Minus PB minus PL by 2 plus PL by 2 plus PB. So PL by 2 cancel, PB, PB cancel. So moment at C is 0. So now the ratio of maximum compressive and maximum tensile bending stress of a beam section subjected to sagging bending moment is 1.75 if the depth of section is 150 mm. The location of neutral surface from bottom surface is 54.54 mm. How it is? So solution, given data sigma c maximum divided by sigma t maximum is equal to 1.75, d is equal to 150 mm. So maximum compressive and maximum tensile stress due to bending are given by sigma c maximum is equal to m divided by I into yc, and sigma t maximum is equal to m divided by I into yt. So sigma c max divided by sigma t max is equal to yc divided by yt. Yc divided by yt is equal to 1.75, that is yc is equal to 1.75 yt. This is equation 1. Second equation, yc plus yt is equal to d is equal to 150 mm, given. So these two, so if we solve these two quadratic equations, so we'll get the yt is equal to 54.54 mm. Now the ratio, a circular shaft of diameter d, small d, is subjected to uniformly distributed twisting moment, t per unit length throughout its length l, as shown in figure. The maximum shear stress in the shaft is 16 TL divided by pi d cube. Oh, see, here is the figure. So we'll solve this. Maximum twisting moment at the shaft is equal to capital T is equal to small t into L, Newton meter. So maximum shear stress by using torsion formula. So maximum shear stress by using torsion formula is given by tau max divided by capital R is equal to T divided by J. So for circular shaft of diameter D, J is equal to pi d raised to 4 divided by 32, and R is equal to D by 2. So this we'll know. We should know this fact. So tau max is equal to 16 T divided by pi d cube is equal to 16 TL divided by pi d cube. Now next, the frame ABC, this is the frame ABC, supports a concentrated load P at point X as shown in the figure below. Members AB and BC have lengths A and L. This is A, this is L. respectively. The strain energy stored by the structure is. Consider the flexure effect only and assume members have constant flexural rigidity EI, capital EI. Answer is P square A square divided by 6 EI into bracket A plus 3L. How it is come? So U total, that is the strain energy stored total, is equal to UAB plus UBC. So UAB is equal to 0 to AB is equal to 0 to A PX bracket square DX divided by 2 EI is equal to P square A cube divided by 6 EI. UBC is equal to 0 to L, 0 to L PA bracket square DY divided by 2 EI is equal to P square A square L divided by 2 EI. U total is equal to add this. So you should know the how to solve the integration. You should know how to add this. And this is simple formula. So thank you for watching the video. If you like it, please do share it and subscribe the channel for more such fruitful videos. So this is the part one. So this way I'm uploading the lectures related with the MCQ or lectures related with the MCQs, solved MCQs with analysis, how these answers come. So this way I will be uploading the videos related to the civil engineering subjects. All these videos will be useful for practice of different competitive examinations like GATE, MPSC, UPSC, RRB, SSC JEE and any other, or some university examinations also. So thank you for watching the video. If you like it, please do share it and subscribe the channel for more such fruitful videos. So next, in the next part, part 2, before uploading part 2, what I am interested to do is I will upload all basic formulas, how to solve the integration or what are the different formulas we need in engineering mechanics or in structural strength of material or structural mechanics or structural engineering. What are the different formulas are required? That video I will upload. So there I will explain only formulas. So that video I will upload and then I will do or I will deliver audio video session on different types of MCQs for different civil engineering subjects. So thank you for watching the video. If you like it, please do share it and subscribe the channel for more such fruitful videos. And see, this is the freely available material, so take its advantage. Thank you.